revenge on Whitney, cut short Bobby Christina's time with her mom.
She needed more time with her mother. And because there were so many people, sometimes Bobby's children, sometimes nieces and nephews, she was always competing for her mother's time.
Robin says it was getting harder to get through to Whitney when she tried to help her friend. She remembers getting a call one day in 1997 when Whitney was in Detroit with Bobby on his tour. On the other end, it was one of Whitney's staffers.
Whitney had been high for a couple of days and she needed me to come there and help her. And she took me to Whitney's room. Bobby walked in and basically just said, "Who called her here?" Bobby asked her if she needed to go home, and she said, "No, I needed to." So I did.
Robin felt she no longer had Whitney's ear.
It was disappointing that she couldn't see that she needed the help. And it was even sadder that he wouldn't allow me to take her home.
Rumors swirled in the press over Whitney and Bobby's troubled marriage and alleged drug use. In 2000, Robin reached her breaking point. It happened as Whitney was about to record the song. If I told you that, with George Michael. Robin bought a gift for George on Whitney's behalf, and she says Bobby went ballistic.
Bobby just yelled, screamed at me. He had done this before. He'd scream in my face, "Don't buy anyone something for my wife. I will trust you. Are you out of your mind?" And at that moment, I left the trailer after telling Whitney that I was tired of being up in my face, and I'm just trying to do my job. And I said, I quit.
She left the job, but she didn't think she was leaving Whitney.
She called me.
"Hey,
so you really leaving, huh?" And I said,
"I'm glad you caught that on video.
That's why I wanted to do it." And she said that we would.